In this video, I'm going to show you how to grade your Apple log footage. So I'm actually recording this video on an iPhone 15, and I just went outside, recorded myself a bit in the log format, and now I'm going to show you how to grade it. So first things first, we are going to go down to the project. Make sure your timeline is DaVinci Wide Gamut, and your output is Rec. 709 2.4. First step is to add two color space transforms. We want to move all the footage into DaVinci Wide Gamut, and then we're going to work from there. It follows the same structure that I always talk about in all my other videos. So all you have to know is what is the input color space and what's the input gamma, because the output is going to be DaVinci. And then from DaVinci, we are pushing it out to Rec. 709. But what is the input color space and input gamma? The input color space would be Rec. 709. Because it's still shooting in Rec. 709. And just look for Apple log. Now this will be your starting point. If you've watched my other videos, I kind of talk about node structure. And honestly, my node structure changes depending on the project. But there are a few nodes that all my structures contain. It's kind of the fundamentals. And those are, we'll do exposure. Next one is contrast. Third one is balance. And the fourth one is saturation. Anything after these guys is completely up to you. But these are the four basics that you really have to know. And I would suggest becoming really good at these four. Let me just label this CST, CST. Now, originally, I always go exposure, contrast, balance, and saturation. But I actually have a different way of doing this now with saturation. I like doing my contrast and saturation in the same node, because when you start adding contrast, you actually start adding saturation. I find it's a very like organic way of doing it. And then my saturation is still saturation, but it's a different type of saturation. I've talked about this, the HSV sat method. What you do is you change that color space to HSV. Take these channels off. And now you have exposure, contrast and saturation, balance, and HSV sat. If you don't know what HSV sat is, I have tons of videos talking about it, but just to recap real quick, HSV sat, if you go up with gain, it is going to increase the saturation of your image and also darken it. If you decrease gamma, it's going to look at your image where is the least amount of saturation and decrease it. So first step, exposure. And now you'll see on my right here, I'm using Omniscope, which is a fantastic piece of software. I would highly recommend downloading it and using it. There are a few ways of how you can run this. You can have a dedicated system, but the easiest way would be installing it as a plugin, and then you create a node on your timeline and just add it here. And I use Omniscope, honestly, only for two scopes. I use it for the false color, and I use it for, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a vector scope here. It's not just a normal scope. It has three circles, actually. So one is for the low range, mid range, and high range of saturation. I only use it for those two. Now the question is, what do I do from here? Well, this is my process. I'm going to go exposure first. And the first node, I'm going to look at my false color. I know skin tones need to fall between about 40 and 60. Now I use my offset and I just go up and down until my face is between 40 and 60, where I kind of want it. If it's there, I know exposure is correct. Now I'm moving on to contrast. I like using contrast, offset and pivot, and that's it. So I'll add contrast here, up and down with offset. I'm literally just looking at the image, looking at my eye. And then I'm also going to go saturation, right? So this is also my saturation. And now I'm playing around with the pivot a bit, adding a bit of contrast. Pivot, saturation, offset, and I'm just going to a point. I'm just playing around with these four knobs and leaving it where I want it. Let's leave it here. Now balance. I think this image looks pretty balanced, so I'm not going to play around with the balance at all. But I do feel like it might be a bit dark because it was overcast when I shot it. If that's the case, I might go back into contrast and I'm just going to go up with gain. Gonna go up with gain, gonna go down with gamma. Now I'm like really fiddling with this image because it wasn't really shot well. I'm gonna try and make it look a bit better. I'm going down with saturation. Lastly, we're gonna go to HSV and sat. If I go down with my gamma, I'm going to decrease the saturation of things in my image that aren't very saturated. So if I go down gamma, up gain, you'll see what happens. Go down gamma, it's going to get desaturated, up gain. Everything that's saturated is going to get more saturated and darker. And this is totally up to you what you want. So this was before and after, before and after. Now what you can also do is actually go in the opposite direction. If you feel like your image is kind of thin, another way of using this set is you go up gamma. So everything that has a bit of saturation is going to get more saturated, and you're going to go down gain. So everything that's very saturated is going to be desaturated, and you'll get this. Oh, I think I reset this. Let me just put this back here. There, there, and here. Okay, so now I'm going to go up gamma, down gain. So this is before, after. I wonder if you can see that. I'm just going to exaggerate it even more. So this is before and this is after. It actually puts life into your image. So I definitely recommend to play around with this gamma and gain HSV set. It's really good. Okay, so now we have that. Now, after that, it's up to you. You can start doing parallel nodes. You can do, you know, HSV curves. Maybe you feel like the face is a little bit yellow. You can start playing with the curves if this the panel works. Can you work for me? There we go. So after this, you can start playing around, right? So after this set, you can add parallel nodes. You can add any type of node if you want to make a further adjustment to this, which is called the secondary adjustments. Let's look at the skin. Maybe we want to go curves. We go hue versus hue. Maybe it's a bit yellow. So I'll change it a bit to red. And I'll go hue versus set. Go down with the yellow. And I'm just making very minor adjustments. Now this is before, this is after, before and after. But all of this would be completely up to you how you want to color grade it. So just to recap, how do you grade Apple log footage? It actually follows exactly the same process as any other clip. You go CST, you change it from Rec 709 Apple log to DaVinci, you work in DaVinci, and then last CST, you're going to push it out to Rec 709 2.4. In your DaVinci, you have your four fundamentals. You have exposure, you have your contrast and saturation, you got your balance, and then you got your HSV sat. If you have those four solid, your image is going to be there like 90% of the way. Then your secondaries come into play. So you can add parallels there. You can add serial nodes there in succession if you want to. And that's where you can kind of start adding power windows if you want, or even, you know, hue versus sat, hue versus hue. But I definitely suggest there's a broad rule in color grading to try and keep it as simple as possible. So focus on these four elements first, get that really good, and then start thinking about your secondaries.